on this single game. So after 5 hours and 46 minutes, it's come down to this.
Back early in the match, you wouldn't know the difference the way these guys are addressing this situation. There's no evidence of fatigue in this point. It's just ball striking and tactics and play, and Nadal blinks first, 15 love.
Talk about hitting your spots at perfect times. Giving him a little bit of breathing space now in this game, serving for it.
Everything should be challenged in this game. If Rafa does break, they reset with three apiece.
So it's a smart challenge, but it's just long.
30-15.
And it buys him a few more seconds of breath before this next point.
Djokovic has two challenges for them.
Well, if you'd seen defensive tennis like this, he just willed himself to get to those two backhands, somehow throw up a half-decent lob, and one of the toughest shots when you're starting to get fatigued.
We shouldn't be surprised that we keep being surprised at just the depths that these two men have been able to go to. So great point for Nadal to get it back to 6-all after 30-love Djokovic. He had his hands almost on the trophy. Need a bit of faith on a night like tonight, don't you? Awesome divine intervention.
But gee, went for it on that point. He wasn't leaving anything to chance. We're back at juice.
Thank you.
Defending champion, going for three Grand Slams in a row. Nothing I can say that can do justice to what we've just seen.
He is the number one. He is the Australian Open champion of 2012 from Serbia, Novak Djokovic.
Well, tennis has a big four, but right now they have two giants at the top.